Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Ninja. In today's video, we are going to see a new application from Neo4j. It's an application which still is in development, but I wanted to introduce you. I'm going to do a couple of videos about it. It's a tool to create knowledge graphs. The tool is Knowledge Graph Builder application, and for the time being, where I'm evaluating the tool, is integrating with OpenAI DeepSeek and Gemini LLMs. Essentially, the tool is using as a vector store Neo4j. You know that it's more than a vector store Neo4j. It's has the possibility to create relationships in between the different nodes, and you will see how what is the approach of Neo4j in that purpose at the time to create knowledge graphs from different unstructured data. So we will see today the installation and basically an oversight of what is possible to do with the UI. We will ingest some data and we will start interacting with the tool, and in a second video we will go to the details and see the different options we have in more detail. So the tool is in this repository. You can download it, install it for free. There is different installation options. We are going to see today how to run it on Docker containers. To some logistics before start, you need obviously, depending how you want to set up, you need different keys to access to the OpenAI API, DeepSeek, and if you want to work with Gemini, you need additionally. In my case, I adapted the code to work with my service principal account. I think the not 100% sure, but almost that you cannot do it. If you run the application in Docker, you cannot do it without a service principal account. And with this, you will access to Vertex AI and the models that you have available there. In my case, I'm accessing the again using my service principal account, and I have access. They had the configuration access to some project that they probably set up for this testing this application, but with the in their configuration they are using interactive login, and you cannot do that when you are running this in Adobe. So the application again is not finished, it's just still in development, but well, I wanted to show you start to introduce you how this kind of stuff is progressing. And as you know, I'm focusing the last videos in RAC, creating different applications. I'm building a RAC application which interacts with majoritarily with Gemini. Here, and using other vector stores, not as sophisticated than Neo4j, because again, Neo4j is much more than a vector store. You can do and use it to model different relationships in between the nodes. Is not only a tool which you will use to localize the more the closest chunk of the document, which is the one that is representing the query that you are doing. It's much more than that, because it allows you to create different relationships in between those embeddings vector that you are storing on the database. But well, we will see in the second video again, we will see all these details. In this one, we will see the installation. Okay, so you can clone this repo into your local environment, and then you had mainly the first step that you need to do, you had here an example that environment file. This is the one that you will need to populate with all the data that you need or you want to work with. So OpenAI key, DeepBob, if you want to work with DeepBob, if you don't set up this key, you will not see this as an option. You need the data of Neo4j. I will show you now how to get it. And for the time being, if you are not going to use with Gemini, keep this on pause to not activate the Gemini interface. If you want to do it, as I did it in my case, I touch this file, score file, and here I just use my service principal account to initialize the Vertex AI API, and then on I patch here the credentials to the model that they are using to do this chat. Under the hood, the tool is using FAST API. FAST API is a tool to create RESTful APIs in Python. It's using as well LangChain, and again, it's working with the different models. You can see here GrokQ with Llama 3. We are working with Gemini. We are working with OpenAI. We are working with DeepBob. So it allows you to work with different models, and you can see now on the front, it allows you to work with different models and also with ingesting different unstructured data files like PDF, Word documents, some others, videos from YouTube, and web pages from Wikipedia, and also S3 bucket from Amazon, where you have to add here only PDFs. So the application itself is two containers. One is the backend and the other one is the front. You also have here some experiments, some interesting notebooks that you can take a look and review how they are working with. Once you had your environment file ready, I have mine here. You can prepare this, just rename remove the sample and just put the keys that you want. You can build the code using Docker compose app build. Doing that is going to create both. If you don't have your Dockers, it will create the Dockers. So to do this, you have to be inside the folder LLM Graph Builder, and you have to have the file like it's writing down here, Docker compose YAML. If not, you will have to specify the name of your file, and this command should vary a little bit. You can do this in different ways. You can also create individually the different Docker files, the backend and the frontend. Backend is a Python application running in FAST API. The front is a React application. I'm not going to enter in how to code in React, JavaScript, this is not my topic. I didn't touch it. And honestly, it works without any problem, so I didn't touch this at all. I just touched some stuff on the backend where I'm more comfortable. It's everything in Python, and I know what I'm doing here. But in the React side, again, no idea. So once you build the Docker Compose, it will create a container with two Dockers, the front and the backend. And then you can take a look what you had in the backend. There is Cipher, is a fast API application which is interacting for embeddings by default with where is you here with the model 4.0, but the embeddings in few words for the embeddings in using this other model, the AL minimum L6 V2, which is a model with a which produce an embedding of 380. I forgot. Well, it's creating these two containers, once you and to access to the application, you need to create a Neo4j database. I'm doing on the sandbox. Sandbox to get a fully complete Neo4j database enterprise. Take the option blank sandbox with data science. As you see here, blank sandbox grant data science, because you need to have the APOC and the GDS plugins installed in your Neo4j. So the grant data science plugin and the APOC plugin, those two are necessary to run this experiment. It's not gonna work. So this is the easiest. You have here for 10 days. You can originally get a database for 2 or 3 days. You can extend it to 10 days. And after the experiment, you can make even a backup if you want to keep the data that you produce here. One more. You have here in connection details everything that you need, username, password, etc. And once you are inside, you will not have the Neo4j database. You can just simply create database Neo4j, and that's it. And this will create a database in blank in the sandbox, and after that, you can start using the application. This data connection data, you can take it here and copy before you compose the Docker container, the Dockers. You create here the URI, the username, password, you copy from the dashboard, Neo4j sandbox dashboard, and the username, password, and URI. Here you have some parameters in how they are going. Neo4j is going to build the graph, numbers of chance to combine, and update 20 every 20 chance update the graph. I didn't find so far time per chance, exactly chance size. How big is gonna be the chunk? This is essentially a size in bytes, that's no wrong. So I need to investigate a little bit more how to do this, how is the application chunking the files, because for what I see is creating a very big number of chunks. Here I upload two files. One is having 360 pages and the other one is 272. And in total, on those, total approximately 515 pages, is creating 3,284. Documents, o sea, notes, which majoritarily are chunk documents. There is only two, we'll see here now, and you can see what is doing in a second. Just create, if you click in chunk, you will see what exactly is doing. It's taking the document, creating chunks, and then on creating some relations in between. Let me next chunk part off. Probably this is more interesting to see. Part off. exactly. You had a document, and you had a relation. The chunk is part of this document. There is other relations like per chunk, part of. You can take a look as well to the last message next chunk. This is another relation that is creating. It's in between chunks. Do you keep the track of the, how the document is organized? Come on. Really slow this. Yeah, you can see here. Part of, you had the document, first chunk, part of next chunk. You can see here. This is chunk, a chunk. Another chunk, the next chunk, next chunk, next chunk, next chunk, and so on and so forth. All these chunks are also part of the same document, obviously. And this essentially is done automatically by the application. You can take a look at a chunk. You have here the heading, the content, the ID of the node, the length, 513, I think this is characters, page number, position, etc., and the text that is extracted. They are legal documents, and cut embedding that is going to be used to create is the embedding is, it will be the one that the database in conjunction with the or together with the LLM will use to provide you answers when you interrogate the knowledge graph. So once you have the containers running, you will get something like that. Let me show you. You get here the Neo4j. You can go to the front and then you will get this. You connect to Neo4j. I had already the connection, but you will get here the data that you need to connect to the database. Is offering you always the connection, the same that here with Amazon Wikipedia, and then only you had the connection in the configuration file. It will ask you just one time, and the next it will be keep it on. Now we are going to process a second file. Now we can interact already with the knowledge graph. We are going just to add a new file, just to you see again. This we will do it on detail on the next video. For example, we are going to introduce this one. So you have loaded. You choose here the model that you want to use. We are going to use again DeepBob. And you, once you have it upload, you just generate the graph. And then on going to the backend, you can see here. Is using the all mini LN blah 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 to create the embeddings, and now once it generates the 20 embeddings, it's processed in groups of 6 and start to create connections, nodes, and relationships in the graph database. So later we will see what this looks like on the dat. Now is again is producing the nodes. Chunking the document in different this document. Let me see how many pages we have. It's 254 documents pages, so it's gonna take a while after this process. Let me check as well. Yeah, still 6%. I'm gonna stop here after the document is fully processed, and later on we'll interact with the three of them. For now, again, it's just creating nodes, more and more nodes here on the knowledge database. You see we already have 3,400 files. Later we will see that we already have three documents. Yeah, free, the one that we are uploading, and at the end we will be able to to query or interrogate all the documents that we have on for you can not necessarily had to be all these documents are legal documents for something that I'm doing. I just wanted to test it with this new application, but it's not necessarily had to be the same. You later on can choose the document to which one you want to interact with. You can see here the preview, or you can later just say, okay, this file is the one I'm going to interact with. You can delete it and you can explore it as well. Loon is a tool which is used in Neo4j to visualize thousands or even millions of nodes. It's performing very fast. For big graphs is the tool that helps us. The sandbox is okay, but it's, sometimes it's running very, very slow. Especially because it's a service that is for free, Neo4j provided for training or for research purposes, and well, obviously they don't dedicate too much resources. So I'm gonna stop here for now. When it's finished the processing, let's take a last look to what's going on here. 1 second, yeah, exactly. Continue chunking, embedding, and creating the different objects on the database. Once it's done, I will. Okay, this is finished. So now, as you can see here, we had 3 different documents. The last one I upload is one, Clasificación de Intervención Quirúrgica por Nomenclator. So we can extend it here. Take a while to expand all the relations, but now once you have the document, you can start interact. You can see here all the chunks and the different relationships that it has created. Now it's this document is 1330 different chunks, only visualizing 100, and now again you can interact. I select, I'm just asking, it's a document, again it's a law document in Spanish. This is from some very similar stuff I'm doing for a project, working with the doctors. A tool that they also using LLMs. In particular, we are using Gemini for that purpose, and we are extracting information from those documents. Here, the approach that is being used by this tool from Neo4j is very similar. In my case, I'm not using Neo4j as a vector store, like we are using Chroma and PyCon to do this, but well, I'm seeing that it's, well, it's not bad. Here I ask for this codification in grupos de anestesia, well, the model is finding the information that you need. We are not going to enter into much details. I want to make a holistic review of the code before do the next video, just to explain you how they are using LangChain and all the details. I'm interested as well in review how they are working with the videos. As HTML is pretty easy, it's just simply with scrapping and then on trash extracting from the text from the HTML the text, and then on creating something similar to what we are doing with PDFs, extracting and creating chunks for the document. Is something similar that you already had some videos that were in the channel. We are using similar techniques to access Google Scholar, Google Solar, and also Google. One of the videos, we use both tools to to create a component which retrieves information from different sources using the APIs from again, Google and Google Scholar. So that's all for now. Again, that was just an introduction to the tool. It looks very, very promising what they are doing. Here they give you a front, but probably it's much more interested to understand what they are doing under the hood because it's probably where from where you are going to get the most interesting part of the of how this application is. The application is running on a page two license, so this means that you can reuse it, you can integrate it with your own application. You just need to mention the license in your code. So well, let's see what is what exactly, or all the details of what the application is possible to do, is able to do, and then on you decide if you want to use it. At least it's not you can take different ideas how they are, well, chunking the information using LangChain, creating these chains as well to interact with the Neo4j. It's essentially a RAG tool using a vector store with a pancet capabilities to search and match information, not only based on the embeddings of the test, also in the relations in the different, which is providing a much more rich search and matching matching and retrieval of the information that you are looking for. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like it, you find it interesting and useful for your job, for your training, or for whatever reason you're watching the video. And if that's the case, give me a like, subscribe to the channel, share with your colleagues and friends to help me with the channel. Thank you very much. See you soon.